At the very end of the game, you're going to meet your mentor, Owl, here, and he's going to give you a choice, either to forsake Kuro or stay loyal to Kuro. If you betray Kuro, you're going to engage in two boss fights, and I'm going to show you those boss fights. One is against Emma, the Gentle Blade, and Isshin Ashina. So this is, not a tough choice, it's the wrong choice, but you're going to eventually get the bad ending if you choose to forsake Kuro. So choose that, and you're going to go down the bad ending path. Now, please note that if you do go down this path, it'll lock you out of the rest of the content of the game and getting the good ending. You'll have to start a new playthrough or go into New Game Plus and start over. So because of that, I highly recommend, before you make this choice, to create a backup save to the cloud so you can reload it. Now, the Emma fight is the first one you're going to encounter. She has one health bar. Basically, what you need to do is counter, or deflect rather, all of her attacks. And then watch out for her two unblockables. One is a grab, and then one is a thrust. The thrust was right there. You can counter the thrust by hitting the circle button, and then the grab, you have to dodge out of the way. Don't just press and tap the circle dodge button, sidestep button. Press and hold it and really run away. You can run backwards, or you can run her right or left. But it's a fairly simple fight. Just deflect all of her attacks. Watch out for those unblockables. There's one right there. And she also does have an AoE attack. It's white, and you'll see her charging up a little white light in the center of her body, center mass. And once that's fully charged, you can interrupt it by hitting her, but if you don't, she's going to set it off, and you can block it. However, you're still going to take damage. Now, once you get through that, you're going to deal with Isshin Ashina. Now, I'm going to use the Shadowrush combat art a whole bunch here. Now, to get the posture, to break the posture, you have to deflect a lot of his attacks. But in order to deflect a lot of his attacks and build a posture, you have to lower his health. And there's very few opportunities for you to actually lower his health. So I'm going to use the Shadow Rush combat art, which is the final one in the Shinobi skill tree, because he can't block it. So I'm just going to basically spam that over and over. After I do that, I'm going to have to make sure I either jump away right away or get ready to deflect attacks. Now, you can whittle his health completely down, and there's an opportunity you can take some health away when he holds the sword up high if you deflect that, or you can dodge it. You can also do counters with his, against his thrust. Be careful, he does have a grab attack, and he also has that same AoE. You'll see a little white light on his hip on his left side. So I'm just going to deflect all of his attacks, and then when he is kind of has some distance between me and him, and he's just kind of standing there baiting you, I'm going to do the Shadow Rush combat art. When he's in a neutral stance and he's just kind of standing there, if you go up to attack him, he's going to sidestep it and then do a counter. So be prepared for that if you decide to attack him when he's in a neutral state. So that is the end of phase one. Phase two is going to begin, and it's exactly the same thing with the addition of these fire attacks, and these are painful. He has three different versions. One, he covers the entire arena with flames, and if you do get burning, you're going to have to use the dowsing powder. And then he also has a cone that he shoots out, and then another one is a wall that appears in front of him. So what I'm going to do is wait for him to do that and try to get around behind him. I'm going to sprint and then jump if you have to get around him. Again, whenever I have an opportunity to do the Shadow Rush combat art, I'm going to do that. There was his big AoE attack, which I did not avoid. It's very difficult to avoid it. You can dodge it. If you do dodge it, it leaves him open for an attack or two. You'll know when he's going to do one of these fire attacks, because he'll stand there and then he'll raise his knee. When you see him raise his knee, prepare to run around him, get behind him. Now, when he's in the corner like he was just a moment ago, it's really difficult to get around behind him. Now, if he kind of crouches to the ground, he's going to do the full arena fire attack. And that one's a little bit more tricky to avoid. When you see him do that, run to the opposite side, and then he'll sprint towards you. As he's sprinting towards you, you can deflect him when he approaches you and then jump over him, or you can just wait for him to get close to you and then just kind of do a small circle around to get to behind him. But in either case, I'm making sure I just kind of watch out for those attacks And then if you do have to heal, whether during this fight or even the Emma fight, you're going to make sure that you get as far away as you can. You want to be on the exact opposite side, because if you're too close, they'll charge you and you won't heal. You'll probably die. So here's his big AoE attack. I did not get around him. He charges you, and then he does his own, that white attack. So very critical that you watch out for those, watch out for his knee or when he kind of crouches down to the ground. But basically, you're going to do the exact same thing as you did in phase one. I'm not getting as close to him and blocking as much as I did in the first phase. In retrospect, I kind of wish I had. Make sure you get that dowsing powder ready just in case. You can equip it on your quick bar if you want. Quick slot. Shadow Rush does damage. Because there are so few opportunities to actually get up to him and cause damage to his health, causing damage to his health, you need his health to be below half before his posture bar is really going to start to fill up. And fill up his posture bar, which I'm not going for, I'm just going for a health kill. To fill up his posture bar, you have to get up close and deflect all of his melee attacks. But at this point, I've resigned myself to just whittling his health. With the Shadow Rush, you don't have to worry about your crosses. You can just keep spamming this ability. Now, let me know if you guys have done this before, but when you get an enemy, a tough boss, and you've been working on him for a couple hours, and you get him down to real low health, do you start to get a little careless? Well, I certainly do. I was kind of pushing it and attacking when I should have been deflecting and staying away. But ultimately, I killed him. I'll get the Isshin Ashina trophy. I'll also get the Shura trophy for the bad ending. As soon as I got that, I'm going to re-download my save that I uploaded to the cloud so I can go and take the other path and get the good ending. So I'll go ahead and let you guys watch the ending cutscene if you'd like it. Hope you enjoyed the video. If you found it helpful at all, please hit that like button and, of course, subscribe.
だが、こちらの守備も上々じゃ。しかし、老いたりとはいえ、あの一心に勝るとは。さすがはわしのせがれじゃの。 これで全て我が手の中よ。アシナもナイフ殿もこの国ごと食らうてくれるわ。我、牛行こんじゃえ。
兵士、民草合わせて 死者数千。生き残りはほとんどなし。アシナは戦国最も悲惨な殺戮の舞台となり、その地には後々まで鬼が潜んだという。